The following program contains adult themes, nudity, and coarse language. Viewer and parental discretion is advised.
It's party time! Put down your clicker and pick up your liquor. It's time for Ed's Night Party! Starring me, Ed Slott, and my co-host, Liana Kay.
Tonight, I get up close and personal with the fabulous Fergie of the Black Eyed Peas. Oh yeah, the rest of the band is there too. Couldn't be helped. And these mesmerizing maidens maximize the mercury in our hot tub. Keep that excitement going for my co-host, Liana Kay. Yeah! Well, it's fast becoming my favorite part of the show.
What's that?
It's almost like the Baywatch credits. Watching you come down those stairs.
Running?
Yeah, it's almost slow. I don't know if you're moving slow motion or just my mind is playing it out that way.
I went down a little slower that time.
Yeah, it was a beautiful thing.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I've never been so happy for gravity in my life. By the way, what is with that? I like the outfit in general, but are you cold?
It is a little cold in here.
Because what, are you going to a church social? What's with that jacket? We're stripey, yeah.
Yeah.
Except I don't have real estate that I'm hiding with a jacket.
Oh, f*** it. There
we go.
Okay.
Now, that's what I'm talking about. And you know what? It helps put me in a better mood because I show up today in the studio next to us. Sum 41 is doing their little show, little concert show.
About.
Yeah, that's what that smell was out front. I show up, I try to pull into the parking lot, and there's kids lined up in front of the... I hate pedestrians, first of all. I think you should... If they're crossing a driveway, you should be allowed to turn them into hood ornaments. That's right. Just as long as you can get someone to hose them out of your undercarriage. So they're blocking my way into the parking lot, and of course you honk at them, and they're freaking oblivious. There's such a camera out there. Is the camera out there? We see this. Look, that's what we're dealing with. Suburban mall food courts are probably empty this afternoon. Screaming. All right, so that's what I have to contend with today. Some 41 fans hanging around the building like lichens. Like zebra mussels on a dock. Plus, they're doing their damn sound checks, which are going to be interrupting us.
Thud.
Thud, yeah.
Thud.
So some 41 fans being out there blocking me from going in,
mm-hmm.
That's wrong. Mm. And it's time for this week's edition of Wrong!
Wrong!
All right. From the fine folks at Keebler, who make some very, very tasty cookies, those little elves, it's elf fudge. Double stuffed. I don't know exactly what's wrong with it, but the idea of elf fudge and then being double stuffed, you never see any women working in that tree.
And oh, the names on the back.
Yes.
There's the Blastmaster Elwood.
Blastmaster
Elwood.
Oh,
it's
no.
There.
Yeah.
There's Buckets the Fudge Splasher.
Oh. Well, that's wrong.
It's very wrong.
In the screen, but don't expect to get it back, ever.
All right, so you know what? I'm very excited about the nap and crap.
Actually,
for those just tuning in who aren't familiar with this, the nap and crap is not a hotel, it's not a motel, it's a no-tel. For people who you're driving sometimes, you feel like you need to nap, or you're somewhere and you really feel like you need to take a dump. Restaurants are customers only. Filling stations are filthy. If you're tired, you don't want to continue driving. Pulling over to the side of the road to take a nap might get you arrested. So this is a place For $40, you pull in, 25 minutes, there's a toilet and a bed, it's clean, Ed's napping crap. You can crap, you can nap and crap, you can nap and not crap, you can crap and not nap. In any case, it's Ed's napping crap. We're in the process of recruiting investors, and I'm actually looking now for the audience out there to help me out. Got a little contest. We're looking for someone to make us a mascot. We're looking for, you know, a cute little cartoon mascot for the night.
Like a big piece of poo with a nightcap on it?
Write that down.
Oh.
Write that down. You see, everybody's helping. You're all contributing. You're going to be invited to the opening of the first Nap and Crap.
Oh. And really, I want to support you on this.
Right.
Okay, and I'm trying to be helpful, but I am not touching those sheets.
The sheets?
Not a chance.
You know, I know this has been an issue for us. Because, you know, people are coming in every 25 minutes. Changing the sheets is going to get expensive. You didn't like my idea of the old using the old hand towel one,
yeah,
where
no,
it sort of
gross.
Rolls around on the medical papers. So I've come up with something. I've worked with my my creative team, and we've come up with a way to have clean sheets for everybody who comes in without it costing a lot of money. You ready?
I'm ready.
Ladies and gentlemen, you ready for this? For the first time ever.
This means you cheer.
Yeah. For the first time ever, the Nap and Crap sheet suit. You see, you come in, you put on a sheet suit. It's a suit of sheets.
You know what?
It's disposable. When you're done, you throw it out. It's all sanitary.
That's not environmentally friendly, though.
Yeah, it's biodegradable.
Oh, it's biodegradable?
Yeah, it's really biodegradable.
A sheet suit.
A sheet suit. This is an innovation. This is a step for, this is like Tang for the astronauts of the Apollo missions. Okay? This is a step forward. And this is also a big step forward in Barry's career. Thank you, Barry.
Now it's not just the Asian guy on set. Now it's the Asian guy in the suit.
Yeah. God love the sheet suit. This is going to be huge, this egg snapping crap. You laugh now.
Huge, like the craps people take in the Nap and Crap?
That's right. Doesn't matter what size. The bowl is there for you. tonight, we've got another person being inducted into our hot tub club. Please welcome Greg. Without seeing that. Yeah, you don't own any larger bathing suits?
You like that one? I got a smaller one there if you'd like to see that later.
Yeah, if it was smaller, I wouldn't see it. My eyes would go blind. Okay, so Greg, tell me a bit about you quickly.
Well, I took an early retirement and got into another form of business, and I thought I'd give something back to society for a change.
And so you showed up here in that bathing suit. Randy, people gonna be in the tub with you, Greg?
Sure am.
Okay, please welcome from pornstarpositions.com, Tiffany and Roxy. Excite him too much. He looks like he could die.
Can we screen for pre-existing medical conditions?
Yeah, we ought to. We need an
underwriter for that tub.
Yeah. Ladies, if you want to give him a physical, by all means. Okay. So why don't we go to this week's low code? Will we check that out?
Meridian, and I'm up here about to shag my thing. Woo!
This is Crystal. Doing a little inventory there. Yep, both accounted for. Getting a little bidet action. You know, you can never be too hygienic in this day and age.
Crystal said she's from something called the Mississippi Meridian, which sounds to me like a cruise ship or a hotel. Or maybe it's just her stage name. And how about that bikini bottom? Yeah, it's a bit of a camouflage motif. It would work great if you're in a pink jungle. Wait, no comment. Oh, she just took two cups from guys along the side of the pool. And from the way they're laughing, I suspect this poor young lady may just have done an unwitting bukkake video. Oh, and forget the pink jungle theory. I'm guessing that's clear cut. Look at that Michael Bolton lookalike guy over there on the... Yeah, there, that guy. Instead of sitting on the dock of the bay, sitting on the dock hoping to get laid. Oh yeah, back to her. I don't know why she's holding onto that plastic cup. Can I point out at least hers are real? Actually, that plastic cup in Mississippi would be considered fine glassware. Oh yeah, definitely clear cut. This is Crystal!
Check in and see if Craig still has a pulse. And we have a little surprise. So don't go anywhere. More on Ed Night.
Stick around, Ed Heads. Coming up, I get it started with hip hop hottie Fergie of the Black Eyed Peas. Yeah, I have to talk to the rest of the band too, but thankfully, I'm not a bunch of tools. Plus, the lovely ladies have more old-age antics with the Ancient Mariner in our wank tank. So stay tuned.
Of Joanne's corset later. She was falling out.
Like to release the hounds?
Yeah.
But let's meet her. She's joining our regular cast. Her name is Joanne. Wow. Hello, Joanne.
I wrote about it.
How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm good. Now,
say it.
I thought Liana was busty, but... You know, I've heard about being barrel-chested, but you're double-barreled.
I know.
Yeah. And when you dance, that's like chocolate pudding in an earthquake.
Thank you for noticing,
Adam. Noticing?
No, I'm just talking about my chest.
Hey, I just noticed you had a face. Where's that noise coming from? Oh, she's got a mouth. Your word for it for the next 10 minutes. Now, do you have trouble like buying clothes?
Yes, I do.
For those babies, yeah?
I have trouble buying clothes.
See?
So we were actually worried about fitting Joanne for clothes for the show because apparently women don't exist in sizes above about 38C.
Yeah.
I happen to be a 34 double D and it sucks.
Really? From where I'm standing, it's actually great. It's all a matter of perspective.
This actually doesn't fit.
To differ.
No, it doesn't. It's too small.
What?
So I started...
Say that again. I didn't hear you.
It's too small.
Yeah.
I don't know how Joanne manages because I have trouble.
Yes, I have a lot of trouble, but I manage. I know what I can wear and how I can move and what will fall out.
And unfortunately, you learn that process by trial and error.
Yeah, really unfortunately, I've never been there for the error. Well, we'll keep our eye on you.
Of course, it is under pressure.
It is under a lot of pressure.
It's under pressure, may explode. That describes both Joanne's top and me.
There you go.
All right, have a hand for Joanne. Hey, in the tub over there, Greg, are you still breathing?
Barely.
Yeah. Hey, are you having a good time there with him?
Oh, we're having a great time.
Yeah, is your name Tiffany?
Did you know that this is the year of the monkey according to the Chinese calendar?
Thank you, and that means what? If you have information that's relevant to this program, that's fine, share it. No. Okay. Here's something that's very important to me. Liana is like our seventh co-host. First female, but since I started many years ago in cable, there have been six people before her that have filled her shoes.
I don't think they're these shoes.
Yeah, they weren't quite as many shoes. The very first guy was a guy named Stan Glass. And I kept in touch with Stan until he fell off the face of the earth. He probably moved in with a woman, which was great because he was in his 50s.
You kept telling him she was a man.
Well, she wouldn't get undressed with the lights on. I asked him to check for a Adam's apple. But I haven't, since he moved in with her, I haven't seen or heard from Stan. I don't know where he is. He could be in a landfill for all I know. She could have been some psycho killer. I'm concerned about my friend Stan. So I need you out there to be like the people in Unsolved Mysteries. I need you to help me find Stan Glass. Now, to help you identify him, I have a little bio tape that we prepared. Why don't we take a look at that?
Good evening, and welcome to the Late Late Show. I'm your host, Swinging Stan Glass. And no, that's not a toothpick in my pocket. I'm just really excited about tonight's show.
Ed the Sock has spewed his venom at a series of co-hosts, but of them all, Stan Glass was the first.
Hey, Stan, is that a new cologne you're wearing?
Yes, it is, Ed.
What do they call that? Wet dog?
Today, Stan Glass is living in semi-retirement in the same small apartment he's shared with his father for the past 15 years. A far cry from his heady days as a local celebrity, Stan now fills his days with quiet contemplation, communing with neighborhood kids, and walking around thinking of what might have been.
I was just a piece of garbage that he just used and threw away. Please excuse me for a minute.
Stan Glass's apartment is full of old bowling trophies, which, like his memories of TV stardom, are nothing but sad reminders of past glories that will never come again. Never one to give in to the crushing weight of reality, Stan still has a message for indifferent TV viewers.
Don't count me out. I'll be back.
All right. So if you have any information that leads to the apprehension of Stan Glass, contact me at ed@thesock.com or your local detachment of the RCMP or the FBI. Yes, there is a reward. Granted, it won't be much. Look at him. But I'm just trying to find Stan Glass. So please, somebody help out. Okay. Well, now that we've had all this fun, why don't we, now that we've had this amateur theatrics, why don't we see somebody who's actually probably a professional in theatrics and head out to this week's Close Encounter. Everyone likes the taste of black-eyed peas, but now that the band has added former Wild Orchid Fergie, there's fresh reason to salivate. And after years of struggling, their most recent CD, Ella Funk, was a colossal hit, catapulting them into the big leagues. Which means, of course, an interview with me.
Lose control.
Well, look who I'm here with. One of my favorite bands, Black-eyed Peas. How you doing, fellas and lady? Everybody good?
Yeah, what's up, man?
Hey,
what's up?
Will I am? Is that your phone you got in your ear?
No, yeah.
Come on, this is like a movie, okay? You want to turn off your phone?
It's off.
I don't want you taking any calls while I'm doing an interview. How about a little etiquette? All right. This whole interview, by the way, is just a thinly veiled excuse so I can get close to Fergie. Hi, Fergie.
Hey, how's it going?
Good, how are you?
Good.
You're a little too far, but shortly we'll be much closer.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, yeah. You're warming up to me already?
I am. I'm looking at your cigar. What kind of cigar is that?
It's Century Sam. You ever heard of it?
No.
Oh, well, you can buy him for a buck. So, what made you guys decide to bring Fergie on board? Did you walk by a mirror?
No. Basically, it was, just sound like a good idea.
Well, I...
To get more girls.
To get more... But apparently that doesn't work, because now more of the girls want Fergie and not you guys.
No. You can't leave the chocolate, homie.
Oh, okay. Well, you know what I say? Once you tried sock, you never go back.
Come on, Papa.
You guys... Don't screw with me, Apple. You guys are all about the peaceful side of hip-hop.
Hip hop is very peaceful.
Well, there's some of the stuff, the East Coast, West Coast feuding. But you guys, not about, as you say, don't want to squeeze triggers, just want to squeeze tits.
Yeah, yeah, we say that too.
And I'm totally with you on that.
Yeah,
that's a bumper sticker message right there.
Yeah.
I'm glad to take this message to the UN for you.
Actually, the UN took us to Vietnam.
Did they?
Yeah.
And when you're over there, did you tell them, let's all squeeze tits?
Nah.
Black eyed peas. Do the black eyes come from you jumping up and down, Fergie?
I don't know what you mean by that.
Oh, you don't? Yes, you do.
Just shut up.
Your song, Let's Get Retarded, they changed it for some other reason, Let's Get It Started. Was the original title, though, Let's Get Developmentally Handicapped?
No.
No, that wasn't it?
Retard doesn't mean, retarded has been like an ignorant thing that was placed upon people with physical disabilities.
Right.
Retarded in the dictionary is a musical term meaning to slow down. And what we mean by get retarded is slowing down our inhibitions.
All right, you want to hit me, don't you?
No, no.
Let's get it started.
Speaking of which, you did a thing with Justin Timberlake.
Yeah.
Come on, you guys are legit. What the hell are you working with that guy? He's tofu.
No,
he's got no flavor of his own. They just drop him into whatever musical genre and he just sort of absorbs. What the hell's all that about?
Justin is very,
I know, he's a very nice guy, oh, by the way, Fergie, I got you something. If you look behind it, Taboo, there's a shirt there. There you go.
Whoa.
That's for you, Fergie.
Oh, excellent.
So wear that proudly.
I will. I definitely will.
I'm sure it'll look a lot better on you than it did on the table.
So, well, thank you.
You're welcome.
I'll be happy to wear it. You kind of look like one of my toys I have at home.
I look like one of your toys?
I think you're a little bit bigger.
Really?
Maybe smaller. I don't know.
It's all about the lube. Okay, Fergie, can I get a little kiss?
Sure.
Come on.
Watch out for the cigar. The weed might...
Oh! Okay, blood rushing from my head. Must go now before I pass
out.
I
slipped the tongue. I couldn't help it.
Well, you're sorry. I'm not. Okay, see you later. By the way, I like giving clothes to you, Fergie, because later on you're going to be leaving some on my ceiling fan. Okay, that's it. See you later, guys. I'm out of here. Peace.
Would be better if we had some titties out here.
You know what I like about you, Greg? Your subtlety.
You know what else goes good with tits?
What?
Ass.
All right. That's it. I gotta go wash my eyes out with iodine. Thank you, Greg. Smartass than a dumbass, and if you don't have anything good to say, say it often. Good night!
I'm gonna make you mine.